The latest version of our game of quoits in America is horseshoe pitching. Here's a meeting of the experts competing for the national championship. Jimmy Risk looks like being the winner, for in this game, four ringers in a row counts very high. But Ted Allen tops him to win the title, a modern William Tell who says it with horseshoes. And now just step back to England, to Stocksfield-on-Tyne, and meet a very lucky little girl who owns her own baby house, where she can have her own friends to tea any time she likes. How many little girls haven't longed to have a doll's house just a few sizes larger than normal, so that they could get inside it themselves? Well, here's their dream come true. It stands 7 feet high and is 3 foot square inside, plenty of room for a table, chairs, and a cupboard for cups and saucers. They say that every morning Mary Ann stands outside her front door and sings, "Mine is a nice house, mine is." And really, you can't blame her, can you? And now, just step to the right, please. Thank you. And we're in the south of France. We are traveling today. A large crowd has turned up to see Bertrand, the well-known canoe stunter, who has announced his intention of jumping with his canoe from the top of a sluice wall to the waters foaming through the sluice gates 30 feet below. The average canoe weighs anything from 50 to 60 pounds, so this jump is a pretty good test of sheer physical strength. A murmur runs through the crowd as they watch for his head to come up. Is he safe? There must be something wrong. No, there he is. If you've ever tried climbing into a canoe without upsetting it, you'll realize how much more skill it must require in these rushing, swirling waters. After so much excitement, Bertrand must feel that to go riding down the river, shooting the rapids, is just a pleasant relaxation.